Hello, my dear friends. In this video, we will going to learn one of the best example, which is related by the displacement of the piston. That means movement of the piston. So what is given? A vertical cylinder. So this is your cylinder, a vertical cylinder. See, my dear friends, a vertical cylinder. So this is your cylinder, a vertical cylinder of cross section area. That means a vertical cylinder of a cross section. So this is the cross section area, and the cross section area is given how much? The cross section area is given, the cross section area is given, A of cylinder is given 0.1 meter square. So this is fitted with a leak proof frictionless freely movement piston. So leak proof, that means there is a closed system, there is no any mass transfer. Frictionless freely movement, that means it moves in a quasi equilibrium process, right? Contains air, that means a ideal gas at a pressure. Initially it is pressure at 120 kilopascal. The air is mixed by a paddle wheel. So air is mixed by mixing of the air by the paddle wheel, which is paddle wheel for 10 minutes. That means during 10 minutes we started the system through a paddle wheel. The running it's run at 250 rpm with a torque 0.5 newton meter. Is driven by a motor during the same period. Motor during that same period, an electrical resistance keep in the cylinder. So there is an electrical resistance keep inside the cylinder and connected to a 24 volt battery, draw a current of 0.45 ampere. So current will draw 0.45 ampere to heat the air. Find the distance in centimeter through which the piston rise, given that the heat transfer from the air to the surrounding. So there is a heat transfer. So there is a heat transfer from the system to the surrounding is 5 kilojoule. And initial and internal energy increase by 2 kilojoules. So internal energy will increase. Now see, my dear friends, we take, this is our system, this is our system. So if we take, this is our system. So first we rotate a paddle wheel, then the work will develop by the shaft on the system. So there is a shaft work, right? And there is a electrical heating. So heater is inside the system, so there is no any heat transfer, only electron will flow to the system, flow across the system boundary. So there is a electrical work, and along with that there is a displacement of the piston. So there is a boundary work. So apply first law of thermodynamics. What is that? During a process, 1 to 2 is equal to delta U plus W 1 to 2. So my dear friends, this is your total work during the process. This is your total work during the process, right? And what is the total work? This is nothing, this is your sum of boundary work plus shaft work plus electrical work, right? So this is your total work, right? And this is your heat transfer. So from here we can calculate there is a heat transfer from the system to the surrounding. So there is a heat transfer from the system to the surrounding. So this is negative, this is on kilojoule. Internal energy increase. So this is your 2 plus W 1 to 2. So what is the total work during the process? 1 to 2, the total work is minus 7 kilojoule. So this is your total work during the process. So now we want to calculate shaft work electrical work and you have total work, so we can easily find the boundary work. Now first calculate shaft work. Shaft work W shaft. So we know that W dot shaft is equal to T into omega. T is the torque, omega. So this is what? This is your power transmitted. Power transmitted through the shaft. This is the power transmitted through the shaft, right? And what is the omega? And omega is equal to 2 pi n upon 60. This is your RPS, revolution per second, right? So put this value. So what is the torque? 0.5. What is omega? 2 pi. What is n? N is 250 divided by 60. So this is your in watt. So if you calculate this value, 13.09 watt. Why? Because this is in Newton meter, so this is watt. But if you calculate, why? Because there is a work in, it is in kilojoule. So it is in kilojoule. So first you find, so shaft power is equal to shaft work divided by time, right? So what is shaft power? Shaft work is equal to shaft power into time. So what is shaft power? What is shaft? If you, this is your joule. If you calculate watt in multiply joule per second, this is your nothing. This is your joule per second. So if you multiply second, so this is joule, but we want kilojoule. So into this we divide 1000. So this is your kilojoule. So what is the shaft power? Shaft power is 13.09 shaft power, and time it is in minute. So 10 into 60 divided by 1000. So this is what? This is your 7.85 kilojoule. So this is your shaft work. This is your shaft work, which is into the system. Now we calculate electrical work. Electrical work. Time. So what is V into I? So divided by 1000. So this is your kilojoule. So if you put all these value, what is V? What is V? V is 24 volt, right? V is 24 volt. Yes, this is 24 volt. V is 24 volt. What is current? What is current? Current is your 0.5 ampere. 0.5 ampere. And what is time? 10 minute into 60 divided by 1000. So this is what? This is your 6.48 kilojoule. So this is your electrical work, right? So this is your electrical work. Now see, we know that total work 1 to 2 is equal to boundary work, that means movement of the system boundary, electrical work plus shaft work, right? So what is the total work? 1 to 2. What is the total work? The total work is your how much? Minus 7. Minus 7 is the total work, right? And what is your, this is your boundary work. You have to calculate electrical work minus 6.48, shaft work minus 7.85. Why? Because this is work into the system, work onto the system. So this is negative. This is negative, right? And total work is also negative. So what is the boundary work? So the boundary work is come out to be, the boundary work is to be, I think, what is the boundary work? 7.33 kilojoule. Right. Now, see. See, this is our piston. Right? This is our piston. And the piston, what is the pressure inside pressure? 120 kilopascal. And this is your atmospheric pressure. And this is your weight of the piston. So this is your fixed value. Fixed. So this is also fixed. So this is your equilibrium pressure. So process will move. Move from 1 to 2 at P is equal to P equilibrium. So what is the boundary work? Displacement of the system boundary. W boundary work is equal to integration 1 to 2 PdV. P is the equilibrium pressure. V2 minus V1. So you have boundary work 7.33. What is the equilibrium pressure? This is the equilibrium pressure. What is the equilibrium pressure? 120. V2 minus V1. So you have delta V, how much? 0.061 meter cube. Right? But the fellow is asking, find the distance through which the piston will travel. So see, my dear student, this is your initial system. This is your initial, which is volume V1. If this is your displacement, so this is your final piston displacement. So this is your V2, and this is your displacement of the piston, x. So what is V2 minus V1? V2 minus V1, this is nothing. This is cross-section area of the cylinder into displacement, right? And we have V2 minus V1, how much? 0.061. What is the area of the cylinder? Area of the cylinder 0.1 into x. 0.1 is in meter. So x is equal to 0.61 meter. So how much it is centimeter? 61 centimeter. So piston will move 61 centimeter. Right? So one observation is that if we take this is our system, this is our piston cylinder arrangement. If you take, this is our electrical heater, right? This is our electrical heater. And in other sense, this is your piston and there is an electrical heater. We take two type of a system boundary. First, in this fashion, reserve system and second in this fashion. This is our system. One in one effect we can take, we take heater electrical resistance as a inside the system and other electrical heating outside from the system. So in this condition there is a electron will transfer from this, so there must be a work effect, that means work electrical, and in this case there is no any transfer of electron, so coil is heating and there is a heat transfer. So in this case there is a heat transfer, in this case there is a heat transfer, right? So there is a work effect and there is a heating effect, and both are same. What is the heating effect? Vi into time. What is work effect? Vi into time. Both are same, no problem. Okay, both are gives the same effect. Either we take electrical heating inside the system, either we take electrical heating outside from the system, but the mode of work, mode of energy transfer will differ. If we take electrical heater inside the system, so there is no any heat transfer, only electron will transfer. To electron transfer there must be a movement of electron, so there is a electrical work. But if you outside heater is outside from the system, so there is no any transfer of electron from the surrounding to the system. So what is that electrical heating? It is a heat the electrical resistance during the passing of current, and then due to heat the heat will transfer from the system to the, why? Because in this case this is your system, in this case there is a surrounding electrical heating, this is act as a surrounding and this is act as a system. So electrical heater, it is inside the system, so electron will cross, but electrical heater outside the system, so there is a heating effect. So one case there is a heat effect, other case there is a work effect, but both magnitude wise same, both magnitude wise same. So if you apply dq is equal to du plus dw, so in first case, so in first case what is that? There is no any work heat effect, so dq is equal to zero. So dw plus du is equal to zero, so what is du? Is equal to minus dw, right? And if you write like that, what is du? Matlab delta u is equal to minus w 1 to 2, and this is nothing, this is minus of minus w electrical. Why? Because work is input, so this is your w electrical. So if this is value, if you input, so add energy, add to the system, so its internal energy will increase. Now in the second case, what is in the second case? In the second case, there is no any work transfer, so what is that? Dq is equal to du, so what is that? Q1 to 2 is what? Delta u, and Q1 to 2 is what? Heat is added to the system, so this is what? This is your electrical heating positive, this is your w, and if heat is added to the system, so this is positive. If heat is added, so its internal energy, so this heat add to the system, so either work effect or heat effect, in both case internal energy will increase, right? So there is no any effect, and in both case the, what is the internal energy increase? It's your Vi into time. Okay, so this is to be clear now. Okay, थैंक यू वेरी मच।